Hi, everybody. It's Jen Almeida, the Director of Communications at WeHaveAFace. I wanted to take some time out to reach out to everybody. I feel like a video chat reaches a lot more sometimes than having to read a long post on Facebook, which we all know that we like and scroll through really quick. So today I want to discuss something that WeHaveAFace has been working on and is so honored and proud to be a part of. And we are working diligently to try to revise the criteria for the HD diagnostics. So basically that means that currently we all know to be able to get diagnosed with HD, we need to have chorea. But we also know that most of us don't have chorea. We may get it later on. We may have spouts where we have it. And some of us just won't get it at all. So we want to rebrand the criteria to fit us, the patients. Ultimately, that means we want to start having the doctors at the Center of Excellence and hopefully further on look at the softer symptoms. We all know those as the behavioral and the cognitive and the psychiatric symptoms, depression, anxiety, social phobia, insomnia, all of those things that we are dealing with every day and struggling with, but it's hard to prove that it's HD and not just you're tired or another ailment that is happening to you. So I want to share my story, and I'm hoping that it gives you guys some hope and some inspiration to share your story. It doesn't have to be a video. It can be a post. It can be something where you private message me and I can share your story anonymously or with your name attached. It's just the more that we can show the doctors that we've been working with internationally the need for our patients to have this change, the better. You know, we always need to have the proof to support what we're trying to get. We are making huge strides, and it is something that is in the works, something that will take some time to plan and have, you know, formally done by the doctors and the people that will ultimately have to write it into history for us. So most of you know my story, but ultimately I want to take a few minutes just to go back and hit on the main things and why this revision is important. I have HD from my mother's lineage. My great-grandmother, my grandma, have since passed due to HD, and now my mother and myself are dealing with it. For me, it wasn't an easy road to get diagnosed with Huntington's. I went to my mother's neurologist, and he recommended that I got the blood work. You know, and that's scary enough, just getting the test and having to wait all of that time. But I didn't have any symptoms when I got the blood work. It was just something that he had known that I had been worried about. And, you know, at a prime time in my life where I need to know how to move forward and plan my future or family and things like that. So I did get the blood work done in about 2016, and it came back positive with a CAG of 43. Number you never forget, I know. So what I did was I searched for HD doctors in my area, more so at that point to get a relationship more so with somebody that had more knowledge and more time to go over what the next steps in the process were, to talk to them about things that I've been feeling. The depression and the anxiety that just seemed different than it had in the past, and not being able to sleep or go out like I used to love to do. So I had found a doctor. We had talked that we had gone over all the symptoms, and simply, and right down to the bottom line, because I didn't have signs of chorea, I was never diagnosed, formally diagnosed with Huntington's disease because of that. It's disappointing and upsetting for the main reason that if you test positive for Huntington's disease, you have Huntington's disease, period. Whether you have chorea or not, we are born with this gene, this mutation. And for them to not diagnose us based on other symptoms that we are having isn't right to us. It's not right to us, not right to our family, our caregivers, anybody, quite frankly. So unfortunately, I stayed with this doctor, I guess expecting a miracle, for about 2 years. And we did some evasive treatments in that time. And then my husband and I just got to a point where we needed a second opinion. We knew that this doctor wasn't going to pull the plug on this of just being PTSD or something that I can deal with just medicines, because, you know, it's something that I am anxious about because I got the test, or because I'm not sleeping because of anxiety. And he wasn't looking in depth into those softer, more frequent and common symptoms. So again, 2 years later, we found another doctor at a center of excellence. And on that first visit, brought him my list of symptoms that I had been talking to with the prior doctor. And he looked at me, he did a couple of other standard tests, and he diagnosed me with Huntington's formally. And I say formally because the non-formal is to the prior doctor, just the blood work test. The formal diagnosis to them or to him was actually being diagnosed by the doctor that I had chorea, or I wasn't diagnosed because I didn't have it. So seeing this new doctor, formally being diagnosed with Huntington's disease because of the softer symptoms that I was having and sharing with him, and him taking the time to actually go through and listen to those, I got the diagnosis and not having chorea. And I can't tell you what a relief it was for myself and my husband and my family. It's something where you feel like you're going crazy. You feel like you know your body, you know it's changing, you know you still may be able to do some things that you used to be able to do, but you might be forgetting others. And to just have a doctor acknowledge that, yes, you know, those things are going to be off, or no, that's not due to that, is so comforting and gives you a new sense of hope. So I guess ultimately that's what I'm looking for. I want to change the diagnostic criteria so that people have that hope, and they can get that hope sooner than a lot of others have in the past. So again, I'm asking you to go to the WeHaveAFace.org page, look on the revision for the diagnostic criteria, and just read about it. Like I said, reach out to me, pop a video up online for us on the webpage. Anything that you want, it could be a sentence, it could be a like on a page, just the support and anything that we can show to the doctors internationally that we're working with is all going to help and make this process more smooth and seamless. So you guys know that you guys are loved, and you guys are my HD warrior and family. So thank you for taking the time to listen to my story, and I can't wait to hear yours.